My name is Jim.
I'm Lauren.
Got you buffalo shrimp with a sauce on the side.
Who makes sauces on?
Hey, everybody, welcome to What the Flick. There's a new Adam Sandler movie in theaters. Hooray.
We actually have a significant disagreement about this movie. This is good.
This is going to be fun. We're all going to trash it.
Ben Mankiewicz, Alonzo Duralde, Christy Lemire, Matt Atchety. Tell us about Blended.
Blended. So, Adam Sandler is a blue-collar doofus widower with a heart of gold. He works at Dick's Sporting Goods. You know this early and often. This movie is brought to you by Dick's Sporting Goods. So he is the father of three daughters. Drew Barrymore is the divorced mother of two sons. And will they get together and blend their families during a wacky safari vacation in Africa? Maybe. Take a look.
Hello.
An avalanche in our backyard. I'll be home right away.
It's an emergency.
I have two wonderful men in my life, Brendan and Tyler.
This t-shirt's on fire!
Africa, sun, sand, safaris.
My boys would give anything to go on a vacation like this.
No more dating for me. It's time and money I should be spending with my kids.
What is he doing here?
Is this a sick dream?
Do I have a new mommy?
So this is not as terrible as the vast majority of Adam Sandler comedies are. And I will
Thank
tell you.
You
why.
Wrong.
I'll tell you why. We talked about this briefly walking out.
So
okay.
Wrong.
So it has a vague semblance of tonal continuity.
That doesn't matter.
Right? Usually they shoehorn in the sentimentality at the end, right? It's all like raunchy, gross out.
This one's like
obnoxious.
That all the way through.
This
Sermon about family. Yeah.
Yes, this has some actual tonal traces of like through lines and thought and planning.
Yes, but tonal,
comparative to most Adam Sandler films.
That is true, and tonal consistency matters a great deal in movies that are even vaguely good. But when you're in the F range, it doesn't make any difference whether your movie is tonally consistent. And I would much rather see movie 43 again,
you point to Alonzo. Yeah.
Right.
It's your movie.
Yeah. Sorry I made it.
So movie 43 apologizes.
But I'd much rather see movies that are not tonally, I guess maybe that is tonally consistent, actually. Or grown-ups too, which are all over the place. First of all, there are...
That's like you want to get shot in the face or shot in the back.
I'd rather get shot in the back. This movie shoots you in the face.
This movie is not as sloppy as most of its movies.
No, it's not as sloppy, but it's worse.
But
because
it's still
in Grown-Ups 2, there was... In Grown-Ups and Grown-Ups 2, there were... It's terrible. I think I gave it a non-existent score, but there are moments of fun. This is a comedy, and there are no moments of fun, none, and it is edited together like somebody who has never edited a comedy before. There are moments where they refer to, where they take a shot of like the people who got married because it was a one-night stand and now they regret it, and we see the guy and the girl, they look away from each other because they know it's in reference to them, and they take that shot after they mention them. Like there's no, it's like edited by somebody I went to Columbia Journalism School with, like where the guys would do stories and they'd leave black holes because they'd be like, well, I didn't have pictures for it, but it was really important. Like it just, I mean, this movie is the worst Adam Sandler movie I've ever seen.
No.
I laughed a couple of times generally when Adam Sandler was not on screen. Wendy McClendon Covey is in this movie and she always manages to fireman's carry her moments into something funny, even in like Single Moms Club and stuff.
Movies that don't
deserve her. And this one, and of course, the second that Adam Sandler sees her on screen, it comes the barrage of your fat and ugly jokes.
Oh, and lesbian jokes.
You must be lesbian because
your company's called Closet Queens.
She's neither fat nor ugly.
Of course not. Yeah, and this movie is just like, there is such a creepy sense of entitlement, again, which I've said before about his movies, of anybody who is not Adam Sandler. You know, you're either too fat or you're too thin or you're too gender ambiguous or you have a funny accent or something. Everybody's creepy and weird and stupid and ha 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 you. Oh God! You know those breathing commercials where the guy has the elephant on his chest? That's what I felt like for this entire movie. This movie was crushing the life out of me.
And it's 2 hours long, and I can tell you this
because
you look at your watch a lot.
Right, and because I had to bring Nicholas with me. Please don't call
Nicholas
child protective
services. I was going to say abuse.
No. What was Nick's line every 5 minutes?
Mommy, I'm ready to leave now. He'd look away from you because he sort of knew the response. He'd be like, Mommy, I'm ready to go home.
Yeah. Where's my car? Yeah. So go ahead, so please.
This is not the worst Adam Sandler movie of all time.
No.
Not even close. I think this movie is harmless. Now, that may be damning with faint praise. I think there's some...
Why is this more harmless than Grown Ups?
Because this movie, they're actually doing something. There's moments in this movie that are actually... First of all, there's actual laughs in this movie. Not many of them.
What'd you
laugh
at? Cancer.
Cancer. Okay. There was one funny line.
That line was funny.
Yeah.
Shaq is funny.
No, he's not.
Shaq's just Shaq.
I thought Shaq was kind of funny in this.
Nope.
I want to see a whole movie with the Terry Crews character.
Like,
that was, I thought that was crazy and insane.
No,
I thought that was hilarious. I thought that was funny.
I had a point two. Terry Crews brought it down.
I think this movie is, it doesn't do a lot right, but it's not, I wouldn't warn people off of this movie. Like, you want to see something that's kind of harmless and it's better than sitting around doing nothing for 2 hours? Fine. That's not the way I felt about Grown Ups.
No, I think sitting around doing nothing for 2 hours, your brain would take you to a more interesting place.
See, that's the way I feel.
You talk to people, maybe learn something.
That's the way I felt about Grown Ups 2. Grown Ups 2 is a far worse movie than this.
No, I agree. Grown Ups 2 is actively bullying you and its own character.
Right. Grown Ups 2 is a movie that, you know, as I said in my review, if you're the type of person that likes that one, you're a bad person. I don't think you have to be a bad person to like this.
That's the one with Taylor Lautner, right?
Yes.
He
was funnier in Grown Ups 2 than anyone came within a mile of in this movie.
No. Yeah.
Look, we have not mentioned Drew Barrymore, who is
lovely.
So fucking charming.
She's very cute.
That she occasionally makes you feel like you are not sitting through one of the worst films of 2014.
Right. And,
but you are.
And because she and Adam Sandler have done two previous movies together, Wedding Singer and 51st Dates, they do have a nice, easy way with each other.
Like, I don't think it came across
when
here.
They're allowed to just banter or whatever, it's
she diffuses
pleasant.
A certain amount of his smarm.
Boorishness.
Yes. But it's not so much that you still want to see this movie or him or anything about it.
The biggest problem with this movie is that it's just the laughs are so inconsistent, and Sandler doesn't do anything funny in this. And I think he's gotten lazy. And I'd love to see somebody actually...
Gotten lazy?
Well, no, he has.
Long since been lazy.
I think, okay, yes, he's gotten lazy in the last 20 years, but early on in his career, like, he was actually working for stuff. And although the critics, you know, the scores for Happy Gilmore and Billy Madison are not particularly high, those movies are funny. Waterboy is funny.
Waterboy, Happy
he's
Gil-
capable
Big
of doing,
Daddy is funny to
he's
me.
He's capable of doing good work.
Yeah,
I think
totally.
He just shows up and, you know, he basically gets a paid vacation to Sun City with his buddies. But I think that if they actually put some effort into this and actually tried to make it funny, we'd have a movie that we would really like. Because I think all of the story stuff that it hits, unlike Grown Ups 2, unlike a lot of his movies, the story that it's trying to tell kind of works. It's not great, but it kind of works.
They're trying to figure out parenting or whatever.
Right.
The moments that I actually like in this or when you get the glimmers of the Adam Sandler that you saw in a film like Punch Drunk Love or in Funny People, like where, you know, when he's just boxing with the one kid or he's talking to one of his daughters or whatever, like the quiet moments where Adam Sandler reveals some glimmers of dramatic capability, he actually kind of nails them in little moments here and there, right? And that's what's
frustrating
because you know he has it in him.
Right. That's what's frustrating because it reminds you what he, you know, it's the kid that doesn't live up to his potential. Whereas grown-ups... There's no glimmer in Grown Ups 2. There's no glimmers of that.
That's why this isn't his worst movie. It's just a bad one.
It's just bad.
Oh, yeah. I'm not saying it's good.
No.
You guys give way too much credit to the fact that there's a story here. Like, I got it. There's a story here. But if the movie's terrible and it's not funny, I don't think that matters.
I was bored out of my mind and I felt like my soul was being crushed, but I didn't feel like I was being insulted by every second of it the way I did in Grown Ups 2.
I guess I wanted to leave so badly.
Oh, me too.
And whereas, like, with Grown Ups 2, I was just, look. Look, this, in a sense,
it's
a silly conversation.
What was the problem?
Grown up, say what?
I gave you some M&M's. What was
that's
the problem?
That's true. He did give me some M&M's.
So
thank you.
We need a sustenance because it's 2 hours.
This
long.
Movie was like being peppered with spitballs. Grown Ups 2 was like having dead fish thrown at your face for 2 hours.
But that's like, and like here's why I think I like that better. Like that being thrown the spitballs is like super annoying, right? But the fish is like, why is somebody throwing a fish at me? Jesus, what's happening here? Like, I'd rather dodge the fish. And Drew Barrymore's just so damn lovely. I hate to, but you know, and it just did to me. He has one kid named Espen in it, hilarious. Mm-hmm. And she delivers one moment of like true performance in it that I thought was good. That was incredibly, you know, maudlin and you know when sort of they've got a dead mom and the moment where she sort of might be willing to let go. Like I'm like that's touching. there was that. That, and so I changed my score during this conversation because I remember that from a 0.0 to a 0.1.
Okay.
I give it a 1.5, mainly for Wendy McClendon Covey and for the joke about the lions and the pig.
The lions and the pig. Tell me after. I don't remember.
But they screwed it up.
I think
yeah, that's a joke about the lions and the pig.
I'm giving it a 4.
No, you gave it a 2.4.
Oh, 2.4. That's good. That makes more sense. Yeah. It's not terrible.
I'm giving it a 4.
2.4. You just said 2.4. It's not terrible. What does 2.4 mean to you?
Well, I mean, like you gave it, it was 0.1.
Yeah, okay.
That's really, really terrible.
But I'm trying to make a point. I don't think we really disagreed. I'm just trying to drive a point home.
It's a matter of degrees.
Yeah. I didn't hate it as much as you did. Yeah. I think it's harmless. I give it a 4.
All right. We give it a 2 overall, which I don't think anybody's really going to object.
And where is it?
It's about 11 on the tomato meter right now.
1 in 9 critics like it. I have trouble believing that. I have trouble believing it. All right. Okay, there you go.
We have no more to say.
We're done here.